This is an interiors project which I've been doing since 2012. It's a brand of restaurants. It's an Italian chain called Chianti. As usual, there is an inspiration. And I think I worked on this design just after a trip which I had come back from. It was with a group of architects organized by the IIA Trivandrum. And I would like to talk about this church, which is in a small village in Medesimo. It's on the border of Italy and Switzerland. So here I met architect Mario Botta. We grew up studying about him, reading about him, and here was an opportunity to meet him. And when we went to his office, he suggested that we actually go and visit this church which he had designed. So there's a little history to this church. The client actually wanted to build this in memory of his wife whom he had lost under tragic circumstances. And he approached Mario Botta. This is the church of Santa Maria degli Angeli on Mount Tamaro. Again, it's Swiss Alps. So this is what you see when you walk in. So basically, you know, it's this long walkaway. When you enter at the level that you enter, it's like a bridge. It's a bridge which ends in a cross. And it actually overlooks a valley, the cross, at a height of about 1,500 meters. So if very quickly, this was the office, Mario Botta's office, which we went and we had the good fortune to visit. These are some glimpses of the church. So there are three volumes in this church. There's a cylindrical volume, which actually has the chapel. There is a long bridge, which is the access. And there is a smaller stepped bridge under which the chapel is. So can you see, this is the cylindrical chapel, is the long bridge which you access at road level. And then, you know, you realize that this overlooks the valley, and below that is actually the church with the entry over here. So it gives you an idea that, you know, this, it's almost like a hidden structure which you don't realize it's there. So in a way, it was a revelation. So this is actually the chapel. What you see on top here, the steps which form the roof of the chapel are actually the steps which connect the bridge to this chapel below. And the whole chapel is, it's like black, you know, it's almost like you're getting into a womb of sorts, you know, it's like, it's such a nice enclosed. And then there are these, there's a lot of drama created with light. At the altar, you see this sculpture. It's actually a painting by an artist. This sculpture over here, it's a fresco of two hands. So it's done by Enzo Cucci. It's actually blue in color, but when the light falls on it, it becomes black and white. So there's magic being created here. The other thing that really struck me about the structure was, one is, of course, the simple form. It's almost like a cross. You know, you have the long bridge, and then you have the side bridge, which is smaller, intersecting at 90 degrees. So there's very simple geometry to the whole structure. Even the furniture for the church is all local wood made by the carpenters, people staying there. If you can see the detail in the furniture, it's all local wood, the joints over here, such simple joints which are continued everywhere, even in the pew seats. You know, the church itself is constructed of local mountain stone, what you get there, you know. So this is the area I was telling you, under the church, where you either be an introvert or an extrovert. Like, you can look, you can, it's almost a meditative space, the space below, which is undisturbed. Or if you want to connect with what's happening around you, you look out through these circular openings. So there's a lot of, I mean, this building has, you know, had a huge impact on me. And sometimes that's the thing about design. You don't know where it's coming from. You don't know whether it's something you saw when you saw it, it's something you heard, something you read. So it's something phenomenal about it. Now coming to the design of the restaurant itself. There was a brief, you know, in a restaurant, they wanted people, though it was a large space, we had to create smaller, more intimate spaces so that people would feel comfortable, you know, and comfortable to spend more time and to have a good time and to enjoy whatever is being dished out. The problem with the space was that it was a very large space and it was completely glass fronted. So how to make this space more intimate and warm? This is the main road over here. There was one service entry here and a street entry over here. So this was a street entry. Basically, this was the site, you know, what you see over here. And there was an entry from here as well. So we kept this entry, we kept this entry. We made this the kitchen so that it could service both sides. So there's an entry to the kitchen. Yeah, there's one here and there's one here. And to connect this L-shaped space that was formed, we made this boomerang shape, so to say, bar unit. And that was it. We had a sit out, an outdoor area. This is how we went about making it more intimate and warm. This is the plan, table settings. There were three key elements here again. One was this bar over here, which was treated as an element. Second was these rafters that we floated from the ceiling. Now the rafters had two functions. One was to bring the height of the ceiling a little lower, and the other was to conceal all the infrastructure, like the AC vents, electrical conduits that we had. This is what it came out as. So again, if you see, the color palette was purposely kept a little dark. We in fact used gray and black paint on the walls because we wanted to make the space more intimate, reduce the amount of light coming in. This is the bar, what you see, which was the first thing you see when you enter from the street. And then we had a complimentary ceiling suspended, like a wooden ceiling with a little bit of a mesh detail over here, if you can see that. And of course, the romance of fine dining with the chandelier. I'm a diehard romantic. That had to come in somewhere. And yeah, and then we used this leather, tan leather, all things Italian, and a bit of glamour with the light. And this is the brick wall that separates the kitchen from the dining area. This is the other entry when you enter from the mall. So you can see that the ceiling has almost become invisible because the focus is all on the wooden rafters, which are suspended, and also the boomerang shaped ceiling above the bar, which complements the shape of the bar. And then these little details on the back of the seating, leather with the pin tucks and everything. So this bar actually is a very functional bar. There is this pizza unit over here. So it works as a pizza table. It works as a buffet table. It works as a wine bar as well. So, and then it takes a little turn and connects the two ends of the dining space. And this is where it converses with the street. So the bar unit, actually, we used ply. This is all recycled ply. Whatever you see, the tables, the bar unit, the cladding, the ceiling is all the wine columns is all recycled ply. And this is all pine ply. Wine columns were built around existing columns so that they would conceal the columns as well as they became a design element. Some more pictures. We kept the brick, as you can see, very raw. There's no finishing on it except a coat of lacquer. This is a night view, evening view, where the lighting really creates a lot of drama. We have this red light on the counter where we have these. Actually, those are casuarina poles, which we've cut into rings and kind of nailed on the bar front to give it a little more rustic look. Yeah, you can see these casuarina poles, which were, sliced and nailed to the front and then lit with a red light, LED strip light. So that's the space. It's a combination of tables and chairs and, of course, bench seating. And the whole idea was to create more warmth.